한겨
Mr. Vice President of the National Assembly of the Republic of Serbia, Veroljub Arsic, Your Excellency Minister Djordjevic, Your Excellency the Ambassadors, dear compatriots, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends. First of all, I would like to thank you for having honored in such a large number our invitation to share with us this historical moment marking November 1st. 1954, the day of the beginning of the national liberation struggle. On that date, men and women in Algeria decided to rise up against oppression, injustice, and humiliation in which the colonial system had kept them since 1830, with the aim to retrieve their freedom, their dignity, and their identity, and to make Algeria an independent and sovereign state. This anniversary is for us a moment of remembrance of our martyrs who sacrificed their lives, and a moment to pay respect to their engagement and their devotion. This day gives us also the opportunity to remember the support given by ex-Yugoslavia and people of Serbia to the fight of the Algerians during these years of struggle, as well as the special role played by President Tito. Today, I would also like to pay respect to Stevan Labudovic, who passed away a year ago on November 25th, and he is not among us for the first time. Stevan Labudovic, cameraman of Filmski Novosti, had accompanied soldiers of the National Liberation Army, and risking his own life, had contributed through the picture to make known the truth about the Algerian war, to raise sympathy of the international public opinion, and contradict the colonial propaganda. Finally, it is the day that marked not only the history of modern Algeria, but also the one of the entire African continent, because the liberation war in Algeria accelerated the process of decolonization in Africa and was a source of inspiration for movement of liberation on the continent and elsewhere in the world. In that context, it should be recalled that the struggle of the Algerian people was in the origin of the adoption of the Resolution 1514 on the granting independence to colonial countries and peoples by United Nations. Today, Algeria remains devoted to the fundamental principles of that struggle and its goals, those being independence, justice, and dignity. The efforts invested into the economic, social, and cultural development of the country are aligned with those goals of the national level, and those references still constitute foundations of our foreign policy. Having suffered the throes of colonization, the Algerian people intrinsically show solidarity with people who fight for their freedom and for the right to self-determination and independence. Hence, on the diplomatic level, Algeria continues to work regionally and internationally for promoting peace, stability, and respect for the international law. This is not a result of the narrow political calculations or delaying tactics dedicated by the conjuncture, but it emanates from a firm and a constant conviction drawn from a liberation struggle that people have the right to freedom, dignity, justice, and peace. With the people of Serbia, Algeria shares a long-lasting friendship forged during the years of the struggle and reinforced in the aftermath of independence through a common commitment to promote goals and principles of the movement of non-aligned countries. Several years ago, Algeria embarked on an ambitious development program which continues despite the contents of the vagaries of a difficult economic and financial climate. I welcome the contribution of Serbian companies working in Algeria to our development efforts and use this important opportunity to call on Serbian economic operators to additionally explore business openings in Algeria, particularly in the fields of agriculture, industry, and tourism. On this centenary of the end of the World War I, I would like to invite you to share a thought for the Algerians who fought alongside their Serbian comrades for the liberation of Serbia and whose bodies lie in Serbian cemeteries, as well as a thought for the Serbian soldiers who found their last resting place in a cemetery in Algiers by the hazard of war. Before closing, I would like to thank the Association of Friendship of Algeria for its continuous efforts in bringing our two peoples closer together, as well as the Barili Choir, conducted by Madame Professor Catalina Tasic, for their devotion to this event and their interpretation of the national anthems of our two countries. Now I would like to invite you to share with us a few delights of our gastronomic heritage, namely delicious Algerian couscous, the Algerian sweets with honey and almonds, and of course, the famous Algerian dates that you all appreciate too much. Thank you for your attention.
Hvala, gospodine ambasadore. Pre otvaranja bifea, ljubazno molimo sve zvaničnike Republike Srbije i gospodine ambasadore da se pridruže njihovom domaćinu i kolegi da zajedno presedu kolač. Hvala.